The Canticle of the Sun, number 496. Please stand.
The heavens are telling the glory of God, and all creation is shouting for joy. Come dance in the forest, come play in the field, and sing, sing to the glory of the Lord. Praise for the sun, the bringer of day. He carries the light, the Lord in his rays. The moon and the stars who light up the way unto your throne.
And let us join the church our prayer in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good morning. Some of you know who this priest is, some vagabond from Saratoga County. My name is Father Joe Cibula. Some people say I'm a retired priest of the Diocese of Albany, and I say nay, nay, nay. I am a senior priest of the Diocese of Albany. I'm still working on the weekends and even weekdays doing funerals and the like. I compare myself to Michael Corleone in Godfather 3. Do you remember that movie, Godfather 3? Godfather 1, 2, 3? Well, in Godfather 3, toward the end of that movie, Michael Corleone, the Godfather, says, "I tried to get out, and they sucked me right back in." I'm happy to be here, and I was telling somebody in the back of church, I really enjoy going to different churches of the diocese the last 2 or 3 years that I've been retired, and I'm happy to be here. And I have roots in the area. I was a associate pastor in a couple of parishes in Albany. I have a cousin who's been dead for several years now, who was a priest for a while. He was at St. John's, Father Karol Blazewski. And so there's always these relationships of life. But here we are to gather this morning to pray. And in the gospel today, we hear Jesus sort of yell at the sea, "Be quiet, be quiet, be still, be still." And I think sometimes in the hecticness of life, we too are called to be still. And so we pray for thy gift of stillness as we share in this liturgy this morning. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins, and bring us to that life which is everlasting. Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, that we may always revere and love your holy name. For you never deprive of your guidance those you set firm on the foundation of your love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Job. The Lord addressed Job out of the storm and said, "Who shut within the doors the sea when it burst forth from the womb? When I made the clouds its garment and thick darkness its swaddling bands, when I set limits for it and fastened the bar of the door and said, 'Thus far shall you come, but no farther.' and here shall your proud waves be stilled. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the love of Christ impels us. More, we have come to the conviction that one died for all. Therefore, all have died. He indeed died for all, so that those who live might no longer live for themselves, but for him who for their sake died and was raised. Consequently, from now on, we regard no one according to the flesh. Even if we once knew Christ according to the flesh, yet now we know him to be no longer. So whenever or whoever is in Christ is a new creation. The old things have passed away. Behold, new things have come. The word of the Lord.
Be with you. This is a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. On that day, as evening drew near, Jesus said to his disciples, "Let us cross to the other side." Leaving the crowd, they took Jesus with them in the boat just as he was. And other boats were with him. A violent squall came up, and waves were breaking over the boat, so that it was already filling up. Jesus was in the stern, asleep on a cushion. They woke him and said to him, "Teacher, do you not care that we are perishing?" He woke up, rebuked the wind, and said to the sea, "Quiet, be still." The wind ceased, and there was great calm. Then he asked them, "Why are you terrified? Do you not yet have faith?" They were filled with great awe and said to one another, "Who then is this whom even the wind and the sea obey?" The Gospel of the Lord. My first reaction in reading today's gospel, especially the part that said, in the midst of the violent squall, Jesus says to the sea, "Quiet, be still." This was my first thought. I have a friend. His name is Vince Ambrosetti. Vince Ambrosetti is a Christian songwriter. He does missions and churches, and I've come to know Vince over the last 25, 30 years quite well. One of Vince's claim to fame is he sang at Mother Teresa's funeral a million years ago. But Vince, in his repertoire of music, has a song entitled, "Be Still, Be Still." And in the refrain of that song, it says, "Be still, be still, and know that I am your God." Consider these three short little sharings. Every afternoon, after putting her daughter down for a nap, the mother lugs a chair out to the backyard and just sits. Sometimes she enjoys the antics of a field mouse or meditates over a bee hovering over the garden or loses herself in the clouds dancing above her. After a half hour or so, she returns to the diapers, the toys, the storybooks, and to find her daughter already recharged, for the afternoon. And thanks for a few precious moments of stillness. Mom, too, is recharged as well. The morning is filled with phone calls and meetings, and like most managers, cajoling, convincing, motivating, fixing, adapting, counting, admonishing, and completing are the tools of his trade. And on the rare day when he can get away at lunchtime, he goes down to the local downtown church to catch the 12:10 Mass, 25 minutes most days. And he hears God speaking in the gospel. He connects with other people who are traveling the same baptismal walk that he's traveling. He's sustained on his road of life with the bread of Jesus the Christ. And he goes back to his office that afternoon, feeling human again. And then there's the teenager. His life is filled with confusion and questions, discoveries and realizations, moodiness and angst. And sometimes the roller coaster of being 16 becomes too much. And so he goes to his room, closes the door, lies on his bed, and puts on his headphones. But the music he plays is not the usual rock music that makes his parents' heads spin and their eyes roll. Rather, it's vinyl. A vinyl disc of wordless, soft jazz or classical guitar. This quiets his nerves and soothes his spirit. In music that he would never admit to his friends he's listening to, this teenager finds sanctuary in the stillness. And although the words of Jesus today were addressed to a sea, I think they're also addressed to us. Be still. At least some of the time, be still. Because our lives can be a bit stormy at times. And like the mother and the manager and the teen, we need to find those moments of peace and stillness in our lives so that we can hear God, so we can hear the voice of God, so that we can recharge and reset our lives, if you will, so that we can live in hope and joy, so that we can live the lives that God created us to live. These moments of silence, I think in our society today, we think is a waste of time. It's not. It's a gift. It's a gift that allows us to retake control of the lives so that we realize that we're not totally in charge, that our God is the controller, the giver of life, the God of love, the Father of all that is good. And so, my friends, in the hecticness of the time ahead, may we find moments of silence, moments of stillness. And as my good friend Vince Ambrosetti would remind us, be still, and know that I am your God. Together we profess our common faith as we pray. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, life of the world to come. Amen. We turn now to our good and gracious God. We ask him to hear our many prayers.
For Christians who have grown fearful and discouraged, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For nations and peoples battered by the raging storms of violence, oppression, famine, and war, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For humility within those of us who, like Job, struggle with the presence of unexplainable evil in our world and lives, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For people and communities where falsehoods depend on the same, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the creativity and perseverance needed to care for the planet, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For faith and trust to mark the level of lives of those who grieve, and eternal life be the hope of our dead in Christ, including Gloria M. Johnson, Francis R. Johnson, Francis J. Johnson, and Adamari Lydia Carroll. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people and situations that we hold deep in our hearts and bring to this holy table, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Father, hear the prayers of all of us, your faithful people. May we continue to become the people of the gospel, of faith, of hope, and love, and mercy that you call us each and all to be. This we ask as always, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, the sacrifice of conciliation and praise, and grant that cleansed by its action, we may make an offering of a heart pleasing to you through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, the Lord humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, gave us eternal life. And so now with saints and angels, we praise you, as without end, we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord, Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his saving death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation. Giving thanks, you held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking in the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. And Lord, remember your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Edward, our Bishop, all the clergy, and all your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus, the Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Now, as Jesus taught us, our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave with you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church." And graciously grant peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always. We offer each other now a sign of peace. Peace, thanks a lot. Thanks. You're going to help me with communion? You're helping with communion?
Yes.
Okay. You want to go? You can go. Okay. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter my roof.
You shall speak a word and for a
renewed and nourished by the sacred body and blood of your Son. We ask of your mercy, O Lord, that what we celebrate with constant devotion may be our sure pledge of redemption through Christ our Lord. Amen. Nice being with you for an hour. Till we meet again, you know, on the journey of life, journey of faith, be still. Find a few seconds. I find that happens at night as I got the television on. All of a sudden, I wake up 2 hours later. The Lord be with you. May the Lord's blessing of the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit descend upon each of you, be with you forever and ever. Go in peace. You're welcome.
Let us go forth singing hymn number 191 in the Baptist hymnal. Glory to his name, number 191.
Down at the cross where my Savior died, loudly proclaiming from sin I cried.
Listen to Amanda for a moment.